Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. I am Explorer A. I hope you all are enjoying my Bahrain trip series. And as I informed you all in my part A of my Bahrain series, that I am going to watch the most famous touristic place in Bahrain, which is Tree of Life, and I will give you a full tour and information on that. So let's start. But before that, don't forget to subscribe and like my channel. Let's start. We reached Tree of Life as I told you before in my part A video of Bahrain series. Let's start with more information on Tree of Life. Stay tuned. The Tree of Life is also called as Shajarat al-Hayat in Arabic language. Is situated in Bahrain. This tree is 9.75 meters high and over 400 years old. Good. It is situated on a hill in a desert area and highest point in Bahrain and 40 kilometers away from the capital city of Bahrain, Manama. The tree is fully covered in green leaves due to its age and the fact that is only major tree growing in this area. The tree is local tourist attraction and is visited by approximately 65,000 people every year. Now this question is how the tree survives in desert area without any sources of water nearby, as Bahrain has very little rain throughout the year. Some research show that the roots of this tree are 50 meters deep, which may be enough to reach the underground water flows. Some people say that the tree has learned to extract moisture from grains of sand. Some claim that the tree is standing on a place where there was once the Garden of Eden, and so it has mystical source of water. In 2009, the tree was nominated to be on the new 7 Wonders of Nature list, but it did not finish on the list. In October 2010, archaeologists unearthed 500-year-old pottery from the soil of nearby area from this Tree of Life. Some analysis conducted in 1990 show that this tree was planted in year 1582. So this full history and mystery of this tree, truly this Tree of Life will make you think about all mysteries which are present around the world with no answers yet. Now we are heading towards Durrat al-Bahrain. While we are on the way, I will provide you some more information on this touristic location. Durrat al-Bahrain is the third largest artificial island in Bahrain. It is located at 40.5 kilometers far from south of capital Manama. Durrat al-Bahrain island includes 5-star hotel, golf course, 12 bridges and a marina. The marina will span 3 of islands and will cover a land area of approximately 0.7 square kilometers, and cost to build this project was about $1.3 billion. But unfortunately, we can't go inside Durrat al-Bahrain as it was closed during our visit. But only their premium members are allowed to go inside. So I can show you only the outer area of these 3 islands. Anyhow, still there are more fun places to go and explore. Stay tuned. Now we are heading towards Al Rifa area of Bahrain. Once I entered this area, I felt like I am in India, as the atmosphere and the vibes of this area will surely remind you of India. We are here to visit Lulu Supermarket, have some lunch in Rifa Mall. Let me show you this place, and after taking lunch, we will go towards Sheikh Salman bin Ahmed Fort, also known as Rifa Fort. Let's go. Visit to Bahrain is really easy if you hold a valid Kuwait residency. There is two ways to get Bahrain tourist visa. First way, to get it on arrival by showing all necessary documents like return ticket, hotel booking, but you must fulfill one more condition, which is that your passport must be valid more than 6 months and Kuwait residency must be valid more than 3 months. Otherwise, you can be denied for the entry. Visa fees for Bahrain on arrival is 25 dinar. Let's talk about the second way. To get it from Bahrain embassy located in embassy area of Kuwait, just you have to fill form online on official embassy website and attach all documents like Kuwait ID, return tickets, hotel booking, and select option of visa for 7 days. So you will not pay anything until you get a call from embassy that your visa is ready. Once you receive this call within 2 working day max, then you visit embassy and pay visa fees, which is only 20 dinar per visa, and collect your visa. This visa process is cheaper than on arrival visa process. Again, this process is before COVID, always remember that. For current process, kindly check with embassy. With the history of Rifa Fort. It was built during the ruling of Sheikh Salman bin Ahmed Al Khalifa in year 1812. In the 19th century, the fort was residence for Sheikh Salman bin Ahmed, and then it was transferred to his grandfather children's. Rifa Fort is known as Sheikh Salman bin Ahmed Fort and offers a great view across the Hunaya Valley. This fort is a historical marvel. It was officially opened for visitors in 1993. This fort also has saffron restaurant inside it, where you can enjoy multi snacks with a marvelous view of Hunaya Valley. This fort is must visit place in your bucket list of Bahrain tour. Heading towards Arad Fort, so stay tuned and be with us in next part C of this series. For meantime, enjoy the way to Arad Fort with beautiful modern Bahrain architecture. So don't forget to subscribe my channel, like all my videos, and stay tuned. I will be back in the next video. So this much is enough for part B. See you soon in the next part. Bye bye.